Tesla is a company known for its vehicles, but it has just unveiled a refreshed and concise version of its three-part ecosystem. It just tweeted its three-part ecosystem as complete energy solution. Tesla's ecosystem includes energy generation, energy storage, and electric vehicles. Three-part ecosystem. The aim of this ecosystem is to provide a complete solution for homeowners to generate, store, and use energy in a sustainable way. Generate, store, and use energy in a very sustainable way. By the way, have you noticed that lately Tesla's Twitter account has become very active compared to the past? So far, Elon Musk has been the face of Tesla. But now Tesla's Twitter account has become more active, posting updates about the company more frequently. This is very well and very important welcome, especially considering Tesla doesn't have a media relations department, something that a lot of reporters were asking media to have someone to pick up a phone or email someone to ask questions. Anyway, the first part of this ecosystem is energy generation using the solar roof. The solar roof is a product from Tesla that allows homeowners to generate their own clean energy from the sun. This energy can then be stored in the second part of the ecosystem, the Powerwall. The Powerwall by Tesla is an energy storage device that stores the energy generated from the solar roof. This energy can then be used to power the home and charge electric vehicles, which is the third part of the ecosystem. It's a nice, complete three-part closed ecosystem that can make you basically independent of grid. So the electric vehicles can be charged using the energy storage in the Powerwall. This means that electric vehicle owners can rely on clean, renewable energy to charge their vehicles and reduce their dependence on fossil fuels from oil or other similar things. In short, Tesla's ecosystem is a complete solution for homeowners to generate, store, and use clean energy. With the solar roof, Powerwall, and electric vehicles, Tesla is providing a sustainable way for people to power their homes and their electric cars, like Tesla Model 3, Model Y, Model S, Model X, and the Cybertruck. Some people raise doubts if Tesla has the manufacturing capacity to support the production of so many panels. The solar panels. This is probably why yesterday the news came out that Tesla was hiring so many people at its Gigafactory in New York that is exceeding its obligations to state. What's going on is Tesla continues to hire employees at Giga New York, as I reported yesterday, exceeding its obligations to the state of New York. At the end of 2022, more than 1,700 employees worked there instead of the required 1,460. According to Buffalo News, Tesla added more than 100 jobs at its Buffalo factory last year. In a report to the state, the company said the factory had 1,734 full-time employees and 107 part-time employees as of the end of 2022. This far exceeds 1,460 jobs that the state required from Tesla. If the manufacturer had not fulfilled its obligations, it would have been fined by the state $41.2 million. Tesla just saved $41.2 million. This is fantastic news for the people of Buffalo at the end of, and for the state as a whole. Tesla has only fulfilled the obligations, but not only fulfilled, but also exceeded the expectations from people, which is good for the economy. The additional over 100 jobs at the factory is a clear indication of the company's commitment to growth and success, and the fact that it has avoided a fine of $41.2 million by meeting the state's requirements, which is a testament to its responsible business practices. This is a win-win situation for everyone involved, and it's exciting to see the positive impact Tesla is having in the area. So Tesla has the capacity to do this ecosystem. So what's happening is this: Tesla is building capacity to support its three-part ecosystem and is pushing it through its Twitter account. And I think this is a pretty smart strategy. What do you think? Agree with that, friends? Tesla tweeted Tesla ecosystem, energy generation, energy storage, and electric vehicles to discuss its complete ecosystem for homeowners. I will have the link of that tweet in the description of this video. You can check out. With this ecosystem, Tesla is taking a step towards a more sustainable future where people can generate and use their own clean energy. I like the idea very much. What about you? One of the questions that was raised on Twitter as a response to Tesla's tweet was whether Tesla was planning to support a vehicle to grid. It's called V2G technology in future products, like in future products. And in case you haven't heard, V2G allows electric vehicles to send energy back to their grid, essentially turning the vehicle into a mobile battery that can support the energy grid during times of high demand. At this time, Tesla has not publicly announced any plans to support V2G technology in their future products. However, Tesla is known for constantly innovating and improving their products, so it is possible that they may consider adding V2G support in the future. It is important to note that the implementation of V2G technology would require significant infrastructure upgrades and standardizations, which may impact the timeline for Tesla's potential adoption of the vehicle to grid. So I think Tesla's three-part ecosystem is very important to ensure we lose our dependence from the oil industry. What do you think, friends? I like the idea of losing or giving up our dependence from the oil industry, from fossil fuels. And this ecosystem is a great idea. Recently, I was in Armenia, my home country, where I'm originally from, and I met a friend who lives in a village, and he was trying to create what he called a close ecosystem. The energy was not part of that yet, but he had, it's like, for example, he would gather the leaves that were falling from trees and build a compost from that to kind of fertilize his yard in a very economic ways. He was raising chickens to have eggs for as a food. He was raising even rabbits to have meat for his family, and also finding ways to gather a lot of water for his for their family's water needs. It was a general nice close system, but energy was not part of it. And when I saw this news from Tesla, I actually sent it to him, the link. Interestingly, I think Tesla saying, "Say, hey, take a look at this. See what you think, because this is a nice close system and can complete your needs for having a closed, nicely kind of independent ecosystem." And we'll just see how it does, but how he will do with that. But I think this is a great idea to close your system, have an independent system without depending on oil, without depending on fossil fuels, without depending on many other things that make your life more dependent from other things. But you know, this will be like off the grid living, getting the sun from your solar roof from Tesla, or it can be probably another company, and then storing that energy in a Powerwall, and then, you know, charging your vehicle, electric, obviously it has to be an electric vehicle, charging your vehicle, and there you go, you have a very independent system using the God-given sun, God-given light. What do you think, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Give us thumbs up if you like this report. God bless you. Have a great weekend coming up, and I'll see you soon in our next report. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section below.